But somebody has to lead. You know, somebody has to have that vision. You know, that vision. It's very, very important that you know where you're going to. You know what you want. And the amazing thing about the universe is that I learned, you've got to want for others the things that you want for yourself. Because it is in giving it to others that you're able to receive it. Know your God. That's the everything of God. You cannot receive in this world something that you're not willing to give away first. Example. Every son would know that if they want money to come back to them, they must pay out the capital. Right? If you want love in the community, you must be willing to love others. Right? If you want to become beautiful, you have to see what is beautiful everywhere. Right? Because only beautiful people are able to see beautiful things. You cannot see beautiful things if you only focus on what is not working, what is ugly, what is not there, right? That's why I see mountains. It's so beautiful, right? So, whatever you notice, and also for your leaders, it's very important that you focus on solutions. And that is the reason why it's in the Bible. Whenever there are two or three gathered in mind, there I am in the midst of them. That is the reason why there is a set of officers. Your leader, your chairman, will not do this alone. He is incapable of doing this alone. You know, when I was younger, just like all of you, I was never a leader. Why? I was so afraid. I didn't know what leaders do. I was a father. Just tell you what to do and I'll do it. But the leader has to think of what to do, right? Are you up for that? Not yet. That is the reason why they're all there with you. Because you think together. It's in the Bible. Two or three, gather in my name. You can say, find one, and then let that one think of all the solutions. And you know, to make the community better, you got to focus and you got to believe that goodness is all around. Because you can't do something if you believe that God has not blessed us with goodness in this world. Right? How can you do something if you know the answer is not over there floating around, right? To solve problems, seeing problems in the world right now, you gotta think about the solution. You can't think about the problem, because what you think about multiplies in your life. When you always think about the problem, you create more problems, right? So what you do is you create more solutions, or you think about solutions. First thing you gotta do, you gotta teach yourself how to be happy. Because you can't serve if you're not happy. Right? You got to inspire other people. You know, whenever they ask me to come over, and she doesn't mean to inspire them. Do you know what it means to inspire? Inspire means to be in spirit. To inspire other people is to remind them that, you know what, you are not that physical body. I know you're limited. I know you can't do everything on your own. That's why we're a community. But you know there's a part of you that you don't see that is unlimited, that is bigger than your physical body. That's your spirit. And your spirit can do anything. Can do anything. There isn't anything in this world. Actually, all that you see, they are not problems. They are opportunities for you to serve. Because all of us are designed so that happiness comes to us when we are able to give it to others first. That's your design. That is why, if you don't serve the community, you feel less happier. I'm not saying you're not going to be happy. But you are happier if you find other people that you can offer your time and effort to. It's so much happier. And another thing, you know, money comes to those who serve. Because abundance is proportionate to the amount of service that you give away. So see? So you're all very, very lucky because you're given the golden created life upon earth, all of you. So congratulations to the new set of officers, I'm sure. Young leaders, right in front of me, and I have to take a selfie or a picture with all of you, because who knows, next governor or guest will come from this set of children, right? And they call you children because they're probably double your age right now. So, congratulations to each one of you. I hope helping others inspires more people to love themselves and love each other too. Because we all deserve a happy community. We all deserve a happy nation. And it starts with you understanding that you've got to make yourself happy first. You don't look for it outside of you. You make yourself happy so that you can make other people happy. You know, the best thing that you can do for the poor or the needy is not to be one of them. You can't help the poor, you're poor yourself. So what you have to do? You have to develop yourself. If all that you do is to read books and to study your lesson very well and to listen to your mentors and then follow everything that they say and then teach that to somebody else, that's all you have to do. And you teach by setting an example. Like, for example, if you show somebody how happy you are, somebody would wonder. How about this person is always happy? I wonder what they are doing with their lives. And they observe you, right? Especially right now, you observe each other in Facebook, right? You always look at what other people is doing and you copy, right? So if it begins with you being happy all the time and being able to serve, you know, your fellow men will copy you. And then pretty soon, probably your club will be the biggest